Hello everyone, I welcome you all to this session. In today's class, we'll discuss on properties of TTFT, this discrete time Fourier transform. In the last class, we discussed about the definition of DTFT and the equation used to calculate the DTFT. And then we solved some problems on DTFT. And this DTFT is mainly used for non-periodic discrete time signals. That is, you will write in terms of vector x of e to the power j omega. And that is given by summation over n from minus infinity plus infinity x of n into e to the power minus j omega n. Yeah, today we will discuss on properties of DTFT. So there are various properties are there on DTFT. So as we discussed in Z transform also, on the properties like linearity, time shifting, then convolution, differentiation in frequency domain, then we'll discuss in modulation, then frequency shifting property and so on. The first we'll discuss on the linearity property. For a linearity property, use more than two signals, and you know that for a linearity condition, it should satisfy the law of superposition. So law of superposition means the weighted sum of input should be equal to the weighted sum of output. So here I'll consider the two signals, one is x of n, other one is y of n, and I'll write if x of n, its DTFT is x of e to the power j omega, and y of n, its DTFT is y of e to the power j omega. So then I'll take z of n is a combination of x of n and y of n, the linear combination of x of n and y of n with some multiplication factor. It's a into x of n plus b into y of n. Its DTFT is z of e to the power j omega is equal to a into x of e to the power j omega plus b into y of e to the power j omega. So now I'll prove it. To prove this, I have to use the definition of DTFT equation. It is x of e to the power j omega is given by summation over n for minus infinity plus infinity x of n into e to the power minus j omega n. Similarly, the y of e to the power j omega is given by summation over n for minus infinity plus infinity y of n into e to the power minus j omega n. I'll write z of e to the power j omega, that is equal to summation over n for minus infinity plus infinity z of n into e to the power minus j omega n. Now I'll substitute z of n is equal to a into x of n plus b into y of n. It's like the combination of the input here. So a into x of n plus b into y of n. So I'll write this as, I'll take this term, a into x of n plus b into y of n e to the power minus j omega n. Take this is a constant term, so I'll take it outside. Summation over n for minus infinity plus infinity x of n into e to the power minus j omega n plus b into summation over n for minus infinity plus infinity y of n into e to the power minus j omega n. And we used the definition of DTFT, and this I can write as x of e to the power j omega, and this I can write it as y of e to the power j omega. Therefore, I can write z of e to the power j omega as a into x of e to the power j omega plus b into y of e to the power j omega. So this is my RHS. So I have taken z of n is a into x of n plus b into y of n, and I will get the answer as a into x of e to the power j omega plus b into y of e to the power j omega. So this is about the linearity property. So next we will discuss on time shifting property. So I should take the shifted version of the input signal, and in the frequency domain it will be a multiplication factor, it will be multiplied. So here if x of n, its DTFT is x of e to the power j omega, then y of n I'll take it as x of n minus n naught. So I'll take the shifted version of this x of n, the shifted by n naught in it. So you can use k also here. So x of n minus n naught. DTFT is given by y of e to the power j omega is equal to e to the power minus j omega n naught into x of e to the power j omega. So now to prove this, I'll consider again the definition of DTFT. X of e to the power j omega is equal to the summation over n from minus infinity plus infinity x of n into e to the power minus j omega n. Light y of e to the power j omega is equal to summation over n from minus infinity plus infinity y of n into e to the power minus j omega n. And I've taken x, y of n is x of n minus n naught. So I'll substitute there. Y of n is equal to x of n minus n naught e to the power minus j omega n. I'll use, I'll replace this n by n minus n naught by a variable m. So I'll consider m is equal to n minus n naught. Then I'll get n is equal to m plus n naught. N is equal to m plus n naught. And now I write this summation in terms of m. So I'll just apply the limit in this. Put n is equal to minus infinity. N is equal to minus infinity, you'll get m is plus infinity, m minus infinity, so m is equal to minus infinity only. Then put n is equal to plus infinity, you'll get the same. So there is no change with respect to the limit. So I'll write summation over m for minus infinity plus infinity, x of n, e to the power minus j omega to m plus n naught. Because n is replaced by, n is equal to what, m plus n naught. Okay, now I'll expand this here, e to the power minus j omega m plus e to the power minus j omega n naught. And the summation is, I'll use a variable m. So I'll take this as a constant term. So I'll write e to the power minus j omega n naught into summation from m is for minus infinity plus infinity x of m e to the power minus j omega of m. And here I'll use the definition of DTFT. So I can write this as e to the power minus j omega n naught into x of e to the power j omega. So this is my RHS. So I've taken y of n is equal to x of n minus n naught, and that's DTFT will be given by y of e to the power minus j omega n naught into x of e to the power minus j omega. So third property we'll discuss about frequency shift. So in the previous property we have discussed on the shift in the time, that is a shift in the time domain. Whereas here we'll discuss on the shift in the frequency domain. So for that I'll consider if x of n, its DTFT is x of e to the power j omega, then the y of n is equal to, so I'll multiply it with some exponential term, write it as e to the power j beta n into x of n. Its DTFT is y of e to the power j omega is equal to x of e to the power j omega minus beta. So you can observe there is a shift in the frequency. So this is my frequency term and there will be shift in the frequency. So this property is called as a frequency shift. I multiply with e to the power j omega, sorry, j beta n, I'll get its DTFT as x of e to the power j omega minus beta. So I use the definition of DTFT, the x of e to the power j omega is equal to the summation over n for minus infinity plus infinity x of n into e to the power minus j omega n. And I'll write y of e to the power j omega is equal to summation over n for minus infinity plus infinity y of n into e to the power minus j omega n. And the y of n I'll write it as this summation over n for minus infinity plus infinity e to the power j beta n x of n e to the power minus j omega n. Now I'll simplify this. So let summation over n for minus infinity plus infinity x of n e to the power minus j omega minus beta whole power n. So here if I'll compare with this equation with the DTFT equation, you can observe x of n instead of e to the power minus j omega n here, e to the power minus j omega minus beta is there. So I can write the answer as x of e to the power j omega minus beta. So this is my frequency shift property. And there you can observe there is a shift in the frequency. So next property we'll discuss on frequency differentiation. And the frequency differentiation means here in the frequency domain there will be a differentiation term will be there, and the frequency differentiation is also called as the multiplication by Ramseck. Be multiplication by Ramseck. The statement is, you, if x of n is dtft is x of e to the power j omega, then minus j into n x of n, its dtft is d by d omega x of e to the power j omega. So prove this. So we have x of e to the power j omega, and it's given by summation of n for minus infinity plus infinity x of n into e to the power minus j omega n. Now I will differentiate the above equation with respect to omega on both the sides. So I will get d by d omega x of e to the power j omega is equal to d by d omega, the summation from n for minus infinity plus infinity x of n into e to the power minus j omega. Now I will write changing the order of differentiation and summation, I will just interchange it. So I'll write summation, let's take it as summation here, and I'll consider this d by d omega, say the summation. So I'll write this as d by d omega x of e to the power j omega is equal to summation over n for minus n plus infinity x of n into dou by dou omega e to the power minus j omega n. This is differentiation with respect to omega. So I'll write this dou by dou omega into e to the power minus j omega n. Next, write summation of n for minus plus infinity x of n, and differentiation of this with respect to omega will be given by minus j into n into e to the power minus j omega n, because I'm differentiating with respect to omega. So minus j omega j n into e to the power minus j omega n. Therefore my equation is summation of n for minus plus infinity minus j n into x of n e to the power minus j omega n. And this equation, if I'll compare with the DTFT equation, can observe here, instead of x of n, here minus jn into x of n is there. So they are taken this, x of e to the power j omega, n for minus n plus infinity, x of n due to the power minus j omega n. So instead of x of n here, minus jn into x of n is there. So I can write, the DTFT of minus jn into x of n is d by d omega of x of e to the power j omega. So this property is called as the frequency differentiation, because you can observe in the frequency domain there is a differentiation d by d omega that is equal to the multiplication by a ramp signal, and again it is multiplied by a imaginary term j. So next we have discuss on convolution property. The convolution property, I'll use two signals here. In a Z transform also we discussed about the convolution property. The convolution in a time domain is equal to multiplication in a frequency domain. So I'll use the convolution operator as a star, and this operator indicates here the convolution. So I'll consider two signals, one is x of n, other one is y of n. So if x of n, its DTFT is x of e to the power j omega, and y of n, its DTFT is y of e to the power j omega. Then z of n, I'll take convolution of x of n and y of n. So x of n convolved with y of n, its DTFT is z of e to the power j omega is equal to x of e to the power j omega into y of e to the power j omega. So here it is a multiplication. So convolution in a time domain is equal to the multiplication in a frequency domain. So I'll write the DTFT of x of n, that is x of e to the power j omega, is equal to the summation over n power minus infinity plus infinity x of n into e to the power minus j omega n. Now y of e to the power j omega is equal to summation over n power minus infinity plus infinity y of n into e to the power minus j omega n. Now I'll take one more signal, that is z of e to the power j omega is equal to summation over n for minus infinity plus infinity z of n into e to the power minus j omega n. Now I'll substitute for z of n is v x of n convolved with y of n into e to the power minus j omega n. And you know that the convolution of the signal is equal to summation of two signals will be given by, that is x of n star y of n. We can write it as we can write this as the summation for n4 minus n plus infinity. So this for this equation I'll write it as the summation over k form minus n plus infinity x of k into y of n minus k e to the power minus j omega n. So this equation you have studied in module 2. This is equal to your convolution sum, the convolution of two segments. So the variable I used k, and here I'll use it as n. So next step is you have to interchange the order of the summation. Then you have to replace this n minus k by some variable. I'll change the changing the order of summation. We get z of e to the power j omega is equal to the summation over k for minus n plus infinity x of k into summation over n for minus n plus infinity y of n minus k into e to the power minus j omega n. Now this n minus k, the n minus k, I'll use one variable. I'll put n minus k is equal to m. Then z of e to the power j omega is equal to summation over k for minus infinity plus infinity x of k into summation over m for minus infinity plus infinity. So I'll use the limit. 10 is equal to minus infinity, I'll get m is minus infinity. 10 is equal to plus infinity, I'll get m is plus infinity. So there's no change with respect to the limit. Now similarly, the n from this equation, n can be written as n is equal to m plus k. This equation is m for minus infinity plus infinity y of m e to the power minus j omega m plus k. So I'll expand this e to the power minus j omega into m into e to the power minus j omega into k. And this summation is, here we used a variable m here, and this is you used the k. So I'll take a constant term outside. So therefore I can write it as summation over k for minus n plus infinity x of k into e to the power minus j omega k into summation over m for minus n plus infinity y of m into e to the power minus j omega m. So this is your DTFT equation. So I can write this as x of e to the power j omega. So instead of variable n, here it's k is there. If k is replaced by n, so you can write n for minus plus infinity x of n into e to the power minus j omega n. So here also, instead of variable n, here it is just m. So this will be, if I'll use replace this m by n, then I'll y of n into e to the power minus j omega n. If I can write z of e to the power j omega is equal to x of e to the power j omega into y of e to the power j omega. So therefore, the convolution in a time domain is equivalent to the multiplication in a frequency domain. So this is like a multiplication in a frequency domain. So I convolved in a time domain is always equal to the multiplication in a frequency domain. So next we'll discuss on Parseval's theorem. And the Parseval's theorem is mainly used to obtain the energy density spectrum. Energy density spectrum of especially in the frequency domain, and almost all the transform techniques will use this, like Fourier transform, even a Fourier series. Okay, if I need energy density spectrum, then I'll use a Parseval's theorem. So here, if x of n is DTFT is x of e to the power j omega, then the summation over n for minus n plus infinity, so magnitude of x of n whole square is equal to 1 by 2 pi, the integral over 2 pi, magnitude of x of e to the power j omega whole square into d omega. Where this x of e to the power j omega whole square is known as energy density spectrum of the signal x of n. So this particular term we call it as the energy density spectrum. So we'll draw the frequency spectrum, and that we'll obtain the energy density spectrum of this. Now to prove this, we'll use the energy equation. The energy is equal to the summation over n power minus n plus infinity, the magnitude of x of n whole square. So this is equation you used in module 1. This is equal to the energy of a discrete time signal. Now I'll write this as summation over n power minus n plus infinity x of n into x star of n, the complex conjugate of x of, that is x star of n. I'll write summation over n for minus infinity x of n. So for this I'll use the inverse DTFT equation, it is 1 by 2 pi, the integral over 2 pi x star e to the power j omega into e to the power minus j omega n into d omega. So x star e to the power j omega into x star e to the power minus j omega n into d omega. Now changing the order of summation and integration, we'll get e is equal to 1 by 2 pi. I'll just change the order of integration summation. This integration I'll write it first, and I'll write this in summation, I'll write it as next. So I'll write it as integral over 2 pi x star e to the power j omega into summation over n for minus n plus infinity x of n e to the power minus j omega n into d omega. And here, as I mentioned, this is a complex conjugate, so this is negative here. So in the general equation, you'll write it as 1 by 2 pi integral over 2 pi x of e to the power j omega e to the power plus j omega n into d omega. Because of the complex conjugate, I'll write this as e to the power minus j omega n into n. So x of n e to the power minus j omega n into d omega. So here, so I'll write it as 1 by 2 pi integral 2 pi x star of e to the power j omega, and this I'll write it as x of e to the power j omega. So I'll use the definition of DTFT. So I'll write x of e to the power j omega into d omega. So in the frequency domain, if I multiply these two terms, I can write this as the magnitude of x of e to the power j omega whole square. So therefore, I can write d is equal to 1 by 2 pi, the integral over 2 pi, magnitude of x of e to the power j omega whole square into d omega. And as I mentioned, this is called as the energy density spectrum of the signal x of n. So in the frequency domain representation here, therefore, summation of n for minus n plus infinity, magnitude of x of n whole square is equal to 1 by 2 pi, the integral over 2 pi, x of e to the power j omega whole square into d omega. So this is called as the Parseval's theorem. Okay, this is important. Old question papers or many question papers, they ask this Parseval's theorem. It's mainly used to obtain the energy density spectrum of a signal. We use this theorem. So we'll consider two signals. One is x of n, another one is x star of n. And if I multiply this, you'll get magnitude of x of n whole square. In the last properties, we'll discuss on modulation. The modulation in general, it is the multiplication of two signals. Two signals I will consider in time domain. And in the frequency domain, it will be a periodic convolution between that. So this is a circular convolution between your two signals. That is a DTFT of two signals. It is x of n and x of n and y of n. So again, for modulation also, I need two signals. I'll consider if x of n is DTFT is x of e to the power j omega, and y of n is DTFT is y of e to the power j omega. Then x of n into y of n, its DTFT is given by 1 by 2 pi x of e to the power j omega circular convolution into y of e to the power j omega. I'll use here x of e to the power j omega is equal to summation over n for minus n plus infinity x of n into e to the power minus j omega n, and the y of e to the power j omega is given by summation over n for minus n plus infinity y of n into e to the power minus j omega n. So now I'll consider this, the multiplication of the two signals. It is x of n into y of n. So this is z of n. So summation over n for minus n plus infinity x of n and y of n e to the power minus j omega n. To obtain this equation, I'll use the inverse DTFT equation, like for x of n. It is substituting x of n is equal to 1 by 2 pi, the integral minus pi to pi, x of e to the power j omega into e to the power j beta into e to the power j beta n into d beta. So summation over n for minus n plus infinity y of n, so I'll write as it is, and I'll substitute for this x of n here. It is given by 1 by 2 pi, the integral over from minus pi to pi, x of e to the power j into beta, into e to the power j beta n into d beta, e to the power minus j omega. Here also, I'll just interchange the order of integration and summation. Therefore, zeta of e to the power j omega will be written as, I'll take this term outside, 1 by 2 pi. So, I'll write this integration here. So, minus integral over from minus pi to pi, x of e to the power j beta into summation from n for minus infinity plus infinity, y of n e to the power j beta n into e to the power minus j omega n into d omega. So I'll simplify this. So 1 by 2 pi, the summation over minus pi to pi, x of e to the power j omega, summation from n for minus n plus infinity, y of n, e to the power minus j omega minus beta. So if I'll take this minus outside here, you can write this as omega minus beta, because one is e to the power minus j omega n, other one is e to the power plus j beta n. So if I'll take minus outside, omega minus beta, the power n into d beta. So here this is 1 by 2 pi, the integral from minus pi to pi, x of e to the power j omega. And here I'll apply the definition of DTFT. So I can write it as y of e to the power j omega minus beta into d beta. So the definition of DTFT I applied here. Now we can observe here, this is x of e to the power j into beta, and here it is y into y of e to the power j omega minus beta. So there is a shift in this. If I'll compare with the convolution equation, there is a convolution of x of n into y of n will be given by x of k in summation over k for minus n plus infinity x of k into y of n minus k. So here one term, this is I can consider as a k. So into the x of k into y of, and this I can take it as a n, n minus k. So instead of that, I can write it as x of into the power j beta into the power j omega minus beta into d beta. So this is, I can write it as x of e to the power j omega convolved with y of e to the power j omega divided by 2 pi or 1 by 2 pi. So this is the modulation property. In the modulation property, I'll take two signals. In time domain, I'll multiply that. In a frequency domain, I'll get in the circular convolution, that is a circular convolution of the two signals. So this is about the properties of DTFT. So you have discussed the linearity property. So linearity property, we need two signals. So I consider x of n and y of n. Then I have taken the combination of the two signals. And on the other side, the RHS also will get the combination of output signal. The second property we discussed about time shifting. The time shifting, I have taken the shifted version of the input signal. In the frequency domain, we are multiplying with the e to the power terms. Then we discussed about a frequency shift. And here also, in the time domain, we are multiplied with the exponential term. In the frequency domain, it will be a shift. So the property is called as a frequency shift. And we discussed about the frequency differentiation. The frequency differentiation property is also, it's like differentiation in a frequency domain is equal to the multiplication by a ramp signal. Then we have discussed about convolution. The convolution in time domain is equal to the multiplication in a frequency domain. So for that, it requires two signals, taken x of n and y of n. So I have taken the convolution of two signals, now output side will get a multiplication. The next property we discussed about Parseval's theorem. The Parseval's theorem we'll consider in terms of energy equation in the time domain. And is equal to energy density spectrum. We'll get in terms of energy density spectrum in the frequency domain. So the Parseval's theorem. In the last we discussed about a modulation. So modulation, it is the multiplication in time domain is equal to the convolution in a frequency domain. So these are the various properties of DTFT. So similarly, there are some other properties also there, like symmetry, then scaling, then your summation properties and all. But you in the properties of DTFT or this convolution, time shifting, frequency differentiation and all, the very important properties. So, and in the exam also, in the model question paper also, they mentioned the frequency differentiation property and the time shifting properties. Okay, thank you.